A proud history of Canadian whiskey. In 1858, an icon is born. What is Canadian whiskey? Canadian whiskey is aged at least 3 years in charred oak casks, has only natural flavors, and is crowned with a Canadian strip stamp of authenticity. To give home brands a boost, the U.S. required all imports to list their country of origin as Canadian whiskey swept across the nation. In 1882, Hiram Walker adds the word Canadian, and club whiskey becomes known as Canadian Club. January 17, 1919, the Prohibition era begins. At the peak of Prohibition, Canadian Club held strong, shipping out 1,000 cases daily. Their first packaging innovation, the gate bottle, curved to fit in small places, becoming known as the bootlegger bottle. Importers such as Al Capone would purchase a case at $7, reselling it to his customers for $75. December 5, 1933, Prohibition ends at last. June 17, 1952, New York City Mayor calls lights out in Times Square to give Canadian Club the spotlight. Canadian Club appears in high-end jazz clubs and opera houses. CC is the essential ingredient in the classic Millionaire's Manhattan. 1967, Canadian Club hides cases of whiskey at remote locations around the world, which sets off a frenzy of thirsty treasure hunters. 9 cases are still at large. Before shaken, not stirred, Mr. Bond's drink of choice in Dr. No is CC and soda. In the 1980s, CC is now enjoyed in over 150 countries. Canada joins the global spirits market with over 1,000 international spirits arriving on store shelves. Entering the modern era, CC plays a prominent role in historical TV dramas. A Canadian whiskey renaissance begins, introducing CC Mixed and Ready Cola and Ginger Ale. Last year, sales of ready-to-drink alcoholic beverages experienced a 4% growth globally. Experimenting with spirited flavors, Dock No. 57 is an innovation sure to appeal to a new generation of Canadian whiskey lovers.